Thank you for watching Poetry in Motion with your host, Dee Freeman.
We can be the change we want to see. It's up to us to choose which attitude to use and how we want to be. It's up to us to choose the friends in our lives, the way we live, in what direction our lives will evolve or how we wish to live. More personally, it's up to you to change your course if you find it not fulfilling. Personally, it's up to you to change your relationships if they tend to drag you down or keep you reeling. It's up to you to decide which change you will construct to become the you you wish and do the things that you somehow must. The adage, if it is to be, it is up to me, is totally true. Nothing changes unless the action comes directly from you. Making the change you wish to be, making the change you wish to see. Be the change. So I use it today to inspire you to be the change today. Be the one to step up. You do what you can with what you got right where you are to become the change you wish to see. Join in with others who are and have been change makers. Mahatma Gandhi used the word best. He was a powerful voice for change. He said, be the change in the world which you wish to see. And so he was. Martin Luther King Jr. used the word in numerous letters and sermons. His dream has changed our world immensely, and we work at keeping the dream alive because we be dreaming change. This dream which has become reality. Yes, a change has come. Malcolm X used it when he told us to love our blackness and be proud of who we are. Ida B. Wells used it when she wrote her newsletter paper editorials and put change into action by speaking out about the wrongful lynchings of African Americans. Harriet Tubman used it when she told the slaves who thought they could not go any further. She said, be strong and move forward or be dead, because there ain't no turning back. Al Sharpton used it when he speaks out for the downtrodden, telling us we all be God's children. Jesse Jackson uses it with his Rainbow Coalition when he tells us, yes, we are somebody. That means we be somebody special. Now, Dr. Mark Lamont Hill tells us to be relentless with hope, be wasteful with love, and always be in the game. Tavis Smiley even says, be real and be strong. Shakespeare said it quite well. He said, to be or not to be. Well, I say to be or to be more. And now our new commander-in-chief says, believe. And yes, we can do it. So let's be about work and change and get busy. Be faithful to it. For without change, we'd be stuck in yesteryear. I want to be that somebody Jesse talks about. I want to be respected, loved, accepted for who I am. I choose to be a woman to take up the challenge to be the best me that I can be. I choose to be here in the now, leaving the past behind. I choose to be bodacious and boundless, be about action, unlimited action. Be proactive, be committed, be down to earth and down to business. I believe I want to choose, and I choose to be a believer and be a leader. I choose to be a change maker, a motivator, a creator. I choose to be an energizer, a mobilizer. I choose to be ready, willing, and able, for if God be for me, who can be against me? The choice is mine, and I choose to be the change if it is to be. It is up to me. And as I choose, I change. So I choose to be the change. What do you choose to be?
I like that.
Hey, do you? Okay. That's a change has come. And I know you've been doing some changing,
yeah.
Haven't you?
Yes.
Well, welcome, Rhea and Ben. Ben has. Passenger,
right.
And Rhea Van Atta. All right. Well, welcome today. And you're here to talk about what change you're making.
Well,
in old house.
Yeah. Well, first of all, I want to say I believe.
All right.
I've been listening to you.
Okay, very good.
Okay, let's see. So changes in old town. Mm-hmm. For me, it's a huge change in my life.
Okay.
But what we've done is tried to fill a niche in old town, which we felt needed a place where we could find good grocery items.
Okay.
That are, I don't know, just healthy foods found locally from local farmers.
Yeah.
Michigan-made products.
Right. All right. And what is your store? The General Store, is it?
It is the one and only.
The General Store.
No. It's the Old Town General Store.
Okay. Yep. And you felt that the need for this, obviously.
Yeah.
Or you saw that there was nothing there that provided that part of niche.
Well, the thing is that Old Town has come such a long way in becoming kind of a destination place.
Yeah, it has.
You know, it took many years to revitalize it. Mm-hmm. But you know, one day when we were just kind of sitting around with friends, having a little discussion about Old Town, because we all love it.
Yeah,
we like going to the festivals there.
Right.
Yeah. Yes. We thought, well, what would make it more complete as a community?
Okay.
So we, first of all, we thought we could use more restaurants, and a nice little bistro bar would be nice, and then another place would be somewhere to buy groceries when you're on the run. Mm-hmm. You know, a good bottle of wine, some good cheese.
Better than, you know, running over to Speedway and getting something.
Yeah. Or if you're a health conscious person and you work down there, you don't want a hot dog from, you know, a convenience store.
Right,
maybe you want to buy some, you know, homemade baba ganoush and some pita bread.
Some homemade who?
You know, baba.
He was one of those guys you were talking about.
Okay, hummus, that's another one. So, excuse me. So we thought, well, you know, I was kind of going through a change in my in my life, and I wanted to do something that was meaningful.
Good for you.
And I wanted to do something that I felt could give back to the community as well.
Yeah. Well, and this is, and you're returning back to the community you came from, too.
Yeah, I read that.
I'm a North Side girl.
Okay. In the community where you grew up.
Well,
what better end is that?
Oh yeah, my, it's kind of like coming a full circle.
Yeah,
and I love so many aspects of my life has gone a full circle. And I think it's just, you know, it's faith for me to be there. You know, it feels good. I feel like I fit in. Mm-hmm. The Old Town community has been very, very supportive.
Okay.
And, you know, just basically coming from the Philippines to the United States, we moved into the north side of town, just down Turner Street.
Mm-hmm.
So that was in 72.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I've seen this area
go down.
Many changes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
And slowly now, get built back up. Yeah.
Okay, and thanks to you, you're helping to do that. Bring it back.
We're hoping to contribute in any way that we can. And also, I think just finding all of these really talented farmers and artists and people who are making products that they keep their money
in
Michigan.
Yeah.
You know, the people that spend money in Michigan, produce things in Michigan, generally will return whatever, like 40% or more of what they generate stays in Michigan.
Yeah. Which is good for the economy.
Yeah.
Now, this building, it has the feel of an old time general store. You did a lot of renovations in order to make this so. The building is a 1930s.
30s.
Yeah,
1930s.
The building itself was in pretty good shape.
Uh-huh.
But, and there's beautiful thick wood on the walls, and it had the tin ceiling and everything. So the basics of it were there, but one thing we did was strip off four layers of stuff off the floor and found these gorgeous wood floors underneath. Oh. So when you walk in, you see these beautiful wood floors, you've got wood walls, the tin ceiling. So it really gives you that kind of nice, I don't know, warm. Yeah, it's got a good, real good vibe to it.
Very, very good. I mean, that's, we hear that all the time.
Everybody keep going,
it smells good.
Right.
Looks good. It's warm. I mean, it's, you know, it's just, I had a vision of what I wanted it to be like and how I wanted it to feel. And I think we've achieved that.
Okay.
Yeah, I think anybody
that
comes
in, you'll have a really nice experience.
Yeah, you feel, I think, I hope you feel right at home.
And I read something about the counter.
The counter was made by a friend of mine. His name is Carl Melms. Hi, Carl. and he's a carpenter.
Okay.
So I commissioned this counter. It's, the top is made out of warmy maple, which is it's a type of maple where a worm had bore into the wood, and where the worm was, there is a discoloration, which is really a scar tissue for the tree. But it's it's just
gorgeous,
beautiful.
Yeah.
And I put 7 layers of polyurethane on that baby. Because, you know, there's a counter. It gets used a lot. But you don't want to be so protective of things that, you know.
That you
like
treasure.
That, yeah. Yeah, but you want to be able to protect it from its use. So same with the floor.
Yeah, the floor.
I remember
it's
cringing
like
the first time the guy brought the coolers, right? They weigh a ton.
Oh, yeah.
He rolled this cooler in there, and I was like, no.
Well, you know,
like,
and
it
put some little scrapes in it, but that's just part of the patina of the whole thing. You know,
I mean, and I'm trying to not freak out over it.
You got to get over those first scratches and whatever.
Yeah,
you know?
And I thought, okay,
make
this
it real,
is life. This
real
is it. Yeah.
Warm and homey.
Yeah, well, that's the way it looks. You know, it looks nice, but there's little imperfections, just like with all of us.
That's right.
You know,
you gotta live with what you got.
Embrace the whole thing.
But it's definitely very eclectic.
Okay.
It does. I think integrate a lot of the new with the old. You know, there's there's something to be said for technology. You gotta have it these days.
Yes. Are you
so
left
we have
behind?
That. Yes. Yeah.
And you talked about your products, organic, local from the Michigan growers or farmers, healthy. Tasty, sustainable.
All of those wonderful things. Yeah, all of those wonderful things. You know, and you say it really well. I have a really hard time because, you know, our products is, I know in my head that it's good for you.
Okay.
All right, but it doesn't. We don't try to be any one specific thing. All I can say is it's good stuff for everyone.
Right. And that's our favorite line. Well, you know,
we have a lot of variety.
Yeah. You know, not everything in the store is made in Michigan, but the vast majority of products are. I mean, that's our first choice is mid-Michigan, then Michigan, then the Midwest, you know.
Okay.
And then organic, if it's organic, that's great, but we don't limit ourselves to that. We do look for companies that try to have some sort of sustainable practices and also give back maybe to their communities, like Cherry Republic, one of the companies we deal with in Higher Grounds, both up in Traverse City. They give back to local
granola.
Organizations. Crunch Granola actually donates a portion of their profits to the Lansing Food Bank. For profits that are sold here in the Lansing area. They're based out of Ann Arbor area. So, you know, we kind of look for that too. And like Rhea said, it's just good stuff. I mean, you know, things we love to eat, things other
taste.
People want. Yeah, I mean, it's
it's healthy food.
Right, pretty much. What about those potato chips?
That's healthy food.
Okay. They're vegetables.
It's one of my favorite things. Okay, I mean, everything in moderation, right?
Right, exactly.
So we have Michigan craft beers.
Yeah.
And we have a selection of course, and especially red wine. So we have a nice selection of Michigan wines, but then we don't limit ourselves to Michigan wines only.
Okay.
So we've hand chosen some wines to have there. And
what, Mooville ice cream, and milk. They're right out of Nashville, Michigan, kind of over near Charlotte.
That's a great place.
Oh yeah, we went and visited, and that's the other thing. A lot of these dealing with local people, we get to meet the farmers and meet the producers and get to know them. For example, I play a lot of music at farmers markets, and there's a company out of Holt called Stone Circle Bakehouse, which makes the most amazing breads. Every once in a while, in my guitar case,
I
get a loaf of bread. We should have
brought some bread.
But it's like, I remember telling Rhea, because she was, you know, when we were talking about the store, I go, we got to have Stone Circle bread. So in March or April, we went and visited Kevin Cosgrove, who owns it down in Holt, got this amazing
stone
1,800
oven.
Square foot stone oven.
In not 1,800, that's a lot.
I'm sorry. No.
18,000
square foot. That's how big it is. It's huge.
18,000, that's as big as my building, honey.
it's almost that big. Whatever, no, I'm the guy, I exaggerate, right?
It's nine by nine.
It's big.
Okay, it's
big. You should have seen the one that got away. Anyway, it's big, okay? And he bakes all this bread in there, and it's all artisan bread made in the European tradition. Mm-hmm. It's got the nice thick crust on it, and then inside it's just, it's so good. And this guy's right down in Holt.
Yeah.
You know?
So he's supplying you.
Yeah. Yeah.
Today
yeah.
he delivered, the bread was still warm.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Okay. Smell it.
Oh,
it's so good.
It's all part of the hominess.
That's a good smell.
Right. Yeah. Exactly.
And that will make people really buy it.
Oh, man.
When we get to meet these people, the farmers, you know, I mean, we know all the farmers that bring food to us.
It.
I mean, we know them personally.
Yeah, and they're not all organic, but they have sustainable practice, which means they'll do natural treatments for their pest management.
Okay.
And, you know, it's just so nice to be able to get something so fresh. Like, we get the vegetables, they're cut that morning, and then we get it in. Yeah.
And we had some asparagus
yesterday.
That stuff was so good.
I go, we were eating it raw.
I go, did you put some butter on this? No. We just heat it up. I go, it is so good.
Oh,
and they're from Feltsky Farm.
I need some food now.
We should have brought some wood.
We just got some cheese in from the thumb area. Oh. Yeah.
We've got pasties coming in from the UP. That's my background. So.
Oh, okay.
Yep.
Okay.
So, and, you know, like gluten-free and vegan. You know, we try to accommodate everybody.
That's wonderful.
We even have pop. Just because.
Just because sometimes people just want one.
Yeah.
That's right.
Just want one.
Yeah. And your grand opening.
Oh, yeah.
June 15th.
June 15th.
Yep.
We gave ourselves a good month.
6 weeks.
And, yeah.
To get
work
things.
Out the bugs, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because there were bugs.
Not those kind of bugs.
Bugs
not in the store.
Right.
No. Oh, man. We knew that they were
going
to be there.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know, just because you're brand new, you're trying to get a groove, go in, a schedule, a routine.
Point of sale system came in like 3 days
before we opened.
So
and
figuring that out.
And yeah. The bookkeeper's going crazy.
But
we'll be ready for the 15th.
You're going to be ready for the 15th. You're going to be doing something special.
I am going to be. We're going to.
Because you have a nice area called the courtyard.
Yeah, we have
in the back.
Beautiful courtyard back there.
Okay.
I mean, it's really, the courtyard's almost as big as our building.
Okay.
And it's all enclosed, and it's kind of a little oasis there amid all the chaos and hustle and bustle.
Uh-huh.
And we've had some landscaping back there. And we're going to have some nice plants, and we're building a stage in the back.
Okay.
And we're going to be able to have live entertainment there. Maybe some poetry readings,
too.
Yeah. Oh, let me look.
I was going to say, do you know anybody?
Do you know anybody? But for our grand opening, among that back area, too, we're also going to have vendors come and have tastings of their foods and what they offer. And they're also then able to talk to the customers about
how
they do business and how they make this and why they did this.
Okay.
And, but music wise, I've got a It'll be my Blue Jello Duo is going to play at that.
Blue Jello Duo.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Doesn't that sound like fun? We don't have any Blue Jello at our store.
Well, you got to get some for that
Darn.
Day.
All right. We might have to.
And we're going to have some people like Mike Aiea from Ritmo is going to be there. Our friend Cindy McElroy, who's a real nice singer. I think you've heard her before. Stan Budzinski, who's a good, great blues guitar player, and a bunch of different people there.
Okay.
Just throughout the afternoon. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be a nice little area. You can sit back there and chill out, listen to some music, talk to the vendors.
Okay. Have a little munchie here and there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
but we'll have some.
And what time is this? And tell us.
That'll
the
be
location.
Between the 12 and 5 will be the actual event, although that day we're open from
11
to 7. We'll probably open a little early because we'll have a lot to do.
12 to 5.
Right. Okay. And it's June 1st.
No.
And
our
June 15th.
We have an event on June 1st.
For tourists in your own town.
Oh,
we're going to work with. But we're at 408 East Grand River.
408.
And it's right next to Pruce's.
Okay.
It's sandwiched between Pruce's and the ATM on the corner.
Right.
Comerica.
Kind of kitty corner from the Unicorn Bar. The old famous hangout there in Old Town.
It's
which
interesting
is great.
Because this building has had this beautiful mural on the side of the side that's facing the west, going towards Turner.
Mm-hmm.
And no one has ever noticed it for whatever reason. I'll tell people it's the building with the big mural
on it. Barbara Ranlovich mural. I mean, it's just beautiful.
It's
big mural.
So I have that mural on my building.
Yeah, it's like a piece of art.
It's beautiful. So come and see it. Come on
down. And see it again.
That's right.
Yeah.
With all the changes.
Yeah. Yep. All with our touches in there.
Yes. So you personalize it. So if you feel comfortable, you know it.
Exactly.
Well, you know, whenever you have, I think, going to a business venture, you bring a lot of yourself into it. And I want people to know who I am. Somewhat.
Not everything.
Not everything. To a certain extent.
Well,
he's an attorney, right?
Yeah.
Well, that's what's different about a place like this than like a franchise or something, you know. I mean, you know, franchise, it's kind of cookie cutter. I mean, you can put your own, you know, little flair in there and your personality.
Yeah.
But, you know, this was really just a blank slate.
Yeah.
Whatever you want.
And it's something that'll always evolve.
Just think of it this way. It's a Old Town General Store. So it tells you where it is. It tells you it's a general store, which could mean a lot of things.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah, so, you know.
We have a lot of room to
A little wiggle room as far as the products go. So we will have little gadgets. You know, like kind of old-timey gadgets for kitchen.
Yeah, just like the old-time bottle opener or even an old-time crank can opener.
Yeah, or, you know, mixer.
Things that you really want to use. You don't need to plug all this stuff in.
Stuff in anymore, right?
All the time.
Yeah.
Because when the electricity goes out, who's going to open the can?
That's right.
Yeah.
And eventually we want to look at bringing in some, like, Michigan-themed products.
Okay.
You know, Petoskey stones, shirts, some different things. Kind of like what Michigania might have used to carry.
Yeah, sort of a...
But, you know, real tasteful stuff.
Yeah. Well, you know, souvenirs. I mean, we do get tourists in Michigan.
Yeah.
You know, and a lot of them right here in the capital city.
You
know, they got to send something home that says Michigan on it. Why not something that has Old Town General Store on it? Lansing, Michigan.
Yeah. So some of your vendors that you'll have that will be participating, you got Zingerman's Dairy.
It's actually, they're called Zingerman's Creamery.
Creamery,
And what they have is gelato and cheeses.
Okay.
We have both products at our store.
So you've got a list of about 8 or 9. And all of these vendors will have their products there. And they'll be able to talk about them.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
If their products actually lend themselves to tasting, then they'll have stuff.
Okay.
Some of the products are not like that. Soulful Earth is body products.
Oh, okay.
So she'll talk about the ingredients of her soaps and her lotions and why they're beneficial for you.
Okay.
And then we also have a Food Shed Farm, Danae Friedheim. She'll talk about probably her organic practice.
Okay.
You know, for growing her foods, and we'll have her vegetables at our store. Mm-hmm. Just, you know, these vendors are all passionate about what they do. Mm-hmm. You have to, in order to come up with such a wonderful product and work as hard as they do to make it available to all of us.
Mm-hmm. It has to be a passion, right?
Yeah,
right,
just like with what we're doing.
Just like the star, right?
It's a lot of work.
It is a lot of work, you know? Yeah, I don't wake up with bloodshot eyes every morning for nothing, you know? It's like, oh my gosh, I swear. It's not just allergies, I don't think.
But you love what you're doing.
Yeah.
So it doesn't feel like work. No. And as you wake up to get into the next day, you're raring to go. Yes.
Well, even
you find energy. You find energy somewhere. It's just amazing.
Well,
sometimes.
Even sometimes when you're dragging yourself in there, but once you get there, we're both the same way. You start talking to people, you know, and it's like you get that energy.
You
like
we
were
so
saying,
happy.
You get so excited, right? Sometimes, you know.
Yeah. Now. You're going to have special music with your
ukulele. Yes, the little ukulele has taken over my life the last few years. I went to Hawaii in 2009, and I stumbled on this big ukulele festival, and everybody was having so much fun. Okay. I'm like, something's going on here. You know, there was like 2,000 people from around the world, and everyone had a smile on their face. Mm-hmm. So we got some things started in Lansing, a big ukulele group. Mm-hmm. We just had our third annual ukulele festival, Mighty Uke Day, week and a half ago.
Okay.
Seems like ages ago now. In Old Town, it was huge. And we're bringing some of that ukulele energy over to the store. Actually, for tourists in your own town, we're going to have a children's ukulele petting zoo.
Now, is it June 1st?
June 1st.
I thought so.
That's June 1st.
Because we're going to go.
Are you going to be a tourist?
Yeah,
we're going to
tour. Stop by because we have tastings of Mooville ice cream.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And there's going to be this ukulele petting zoo.
For kids. So they
and sidewalk chalking in front of the store.
Okay.
But this is in conjunction with Pruce's. They were kind enough to invite me to join up with them because they're a great neighbor.
Okay. Yep.
And because there's something you kind of have to sign up a long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
But since we were right there next to each other, we thought, we'll work together.
Yeah. So the next couple of weeks, we've got a lot
stuff
of things going on.
Okay. I think we might even actually have an art showing in the courtyard this year.
Okay.
And I'm hoping I've got a couple.
Well, you have to come back and share that.
Yeah.
But we're about out of time, so tell us one more time where and if you would like to leave a contact.
I'll go where.
Yeah.
Yeah, you do the contact.
You do the where.
Okay, we are Old Town General Store.
Okay.
Located at 408 East Grand River in Lansing, Michigan, 48906.
Okay.
Wow.
And you can go to www.oldtown-generalstore.com.
Uh-huh.
Or we have a really active Facebook page, which everybody's really been involved with a lot of pictures.
Uh-huh.
And come on in.
All right, I'll have to check you out.
Yeah, definitely. Like us.
Like us and come out.
Yep.
408
East Grand River.
Okay,
Old Town.
June 15th is the grand opening. It's open 11 to 7, but the function is actually noon to 5.
Right.
Correct.
Okay. Well, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you,
good to see you.
Thank you so much. Thank you out there for watching. Be proud. Be productive. By all means, be blessed.
Tune in next week for more messages of blessings and inspiration. Guests sharing life and education. Words of powerful motivation. And editorials for deep contemplation. Until then, be blessed.